Jeremiah 31, I had a question coming out of section 3.4, number 97. And this is where we were given a couple of functions. We were given a function that represents the number of bacteria in some food based on its temperature. And we were also told that the temperature of the food depends on how much time it's been out of the refrigerator. And just as a note, I want you to take note that this slope here of this line is positive. And that's because if you take food out of a refrigerator, it's going to get warmer. So that's why this has a positive slope, because food heats up once you put it into room temperature. So we are told here to find the composite function n of capital T of lower T. So I'm going to start this the same way I would every composite function. I'm going to go ahead and substitute out that innermost parentheses, right? So we were told T of capital T of little t is equal to 5t plus 1.5. So that is what I'm putting in here. Actually, let me just change the color on it. All right, so I'm plugging that in here. And then this becomes, my new x coordinate, if you will. I get that it's got a variable in it. But the idea here, the function says whatever's in that parentheses for the n, you put it here, you put it here, right? So if I have 5t plus 1.5, I'm going to take 23 times that thing squared, minus 56 of that thing, and I'm going to add 1 to it. So that's what you see me doing. I'm substituting that in right here and substituting that in right here. And now it becomes just a really, really good time of foiling everything out and collecting like terms. So once I foil everything out and collect like terms, here is my function that I've been asked to find. All right. And then it says find the time. So for part B, when it says find the time, and the directions, that's saying find little t. So find the time when the bacteria count reaches 6,752. So I basically want to set this thing equal to 6,752 and solve for little t here. And that's what you see me doing here. Now I have a quadratic function. There are three ways to solve a quadratic function, right? You could go ahead and try and factor it. You could use the quadratic formula, or you could complete the square. Now, for me personally, I don't want to factor this thing. It doesn't look too nice, and factoring doesn't always work, so I'm not going to use that. These two will always work, all right? Always work. They will always get you an answer, but if I can avoid completing the square, I will. So the option I'm going to go with right here is to use the quadratic formula, but in order to use the quadratic formula, I need to have 0 on this side. So what I'm going to do is subtract 6,752 to this side of the equation, and that's where you see me going here. So now what I'm doing is I'm running the quadratic formula with A being 575, B being 65, and C being this beast here. And I kind of cheated in that I have a program built into my calculator, and so I ran through it. If I needed to do it the long way, just so you could see it, right, T would be equal to, we would have to do negative B plus or minus the square root of B squared minus 4 times A times C. Oops, that's a 3. All right. And then I would have to do all of that over 2A. And again, I'm not going to go through all of this, but if you messed with this expression, if you crunch those numbers, you're going to get positive 3.3 and negative 3.491. But the thing is, we're talking about time, right? So in the context of this question, you can't have a negative time. So this has to be my answer. And it said to round to 2 decimals, so I'm going to go to this decimal place. But because this number over here is larger than 5, I'm going to round up, which is why you see me saying 3.38 hours. All right. Thanks so much, everyone. Bye.